Rise to speak on the natural calamity, the cyclone Okhi, which took place in south of India and affected the states of Kerala, Tamil Nadu and the Union Territory of Lakshadweep very badly. According to estimates, 120 people have died from Tamil Nadu and Kerala. In Kerala, it is reported that 77 people have died. 100 are missing. About 1,000 houses have been destroyed. Sir, on behalf of the people of West Bengal, I extend my sympathies to the people of these states and condolences to the families who have lost their people. It's a terrible thing to be caught in an open sea in a cyclone. It shows how helpless man is against nature. With small fishing boats to go out fishing deep into the sea and then the cyclone strikes, the sea becomes unruly, human beings are helpless. And that is what happened in Kerala and Lakshadweep and Tamil Nadu, especially in the district of Kanyakumari, which I'll describe a little later. Sir, since the cyclone, the Kerala government has announced 25 lakhs to those who have died. Tamil Nadu government has allotted rupees 20 lakhs to the families of those who have died, and help is being extended. The Kerala government and Tamil Nadu government have also submitted their demands to the government of India, and I would ask the Home Minister, even yesterday we learnt that the centre has not yet sent its team. Only after the team goes, makes his report, comes back to the Home Minister, then the meeting will be held and then the money will be released. At this point, we must reach succor to those who have been harmed by the Okhi, those whose boats have been destroyed, those whose houses have been destroyed, those who have lost the next of kith and kin. But while we discuss Okhi, one or two points needs to be mentioned. That while nobody can prevent a natural calamity, what human beings can do is to give advance warning so that people can take precaution. Unfortunate thing is that the cyclone had its landfall on the morning of 30th November. The Indian Meteorological Department issued its cyclone warning at noon at that day. Most of the people had gone out into the sea by that time. So the warning did not reach them. Now two points are cited. A is that people are in the west coast are not used to cyclones. People in Odisha, your state, or in Andhra, or the eastern seaboard of Tamil Nadu are more used to cyclone. We had Phailin, we had Hudhud, and we had the worst super cyclone in Odisha in 1999. There, the early warning system is in place. In Kerala particularly, this early warning system failed. I do not want to go into accusation, but the Kerala Chief Minister, Mr. Pinarayi Vijayan, whether he has done it politically or not, he has openly alleged that he was not, Kerala was not warned about the cyclone by the center. No advance warning on cyclone, Kerala CM. Vijayan said first information the state government got was on 30th noon. There is no advance information of cyclone Oki at all. Our colleague Mr. Shashi Tharoor has written a letter to the center to inquire into why there was this lapse in warning people. Then much loss of lives could have been avoided and maybe much damage to property could have been avoided. Sir, you realize the problem with this cyclone was that this originated in the southwest of Sri Lanka. Normally what happens, cyclones travel upwards at the rate of 13-14 kilometers an hour. What happened is that it was coming north, people expected it to go towards Maldives. But instead of going towards Maldives, it came towards the Lakshadweep and the Kerala side. People were taken totally by surprise. And as I said, that normally Arabian Sea is cooler than Bay of Bengal. As a result of which, less cyclones take place in the Arabian Sea than in the Bay of Bengal. And that has led to a state of mind. So what is immediately necessary is to look into the early warning systems in place in Kerala and in the southern part of Tamil Nadu, as also Lakshadweep. Lakshadweep, the picturesque island I have been to, is totally small parts in the middle of the sea. People are helpless in Lakshadweep, in Kavarati, and all these places. Minicoy and Kalpini have been affected, not Lakshadweep. Yes, either Lakshadweep and Minicoy Islands is called. So, this early warning system ought to be in place and a regime and a routine worked out in proper. Sir, nobody knows how many people have been missing. Still, Nirmala Sitharaman, our defense minister, went on the 4th of December. But still, the Indian Navy is searching. Sir, there is also a complaint. There was a delay by the Coast Guard and the Navy in putting their ships into action. And in Kerala and particularly in Tamil Nadu, fishermen have complained that they told the Coast Guards, take some local fishermen with you on the ship. Because we know where fishermen go to find the shoals of fish. But the Coast Guard refused in the initial stage. So, in our inquiry, we must find out why there was no sufficient early warning, why the Coast Guard refused to cooperate with the fishermen and their representatives. The center has given 325 crores up till now. The Kerala government has sought a ₹7,340 crore package. The Tamil Nadu government also, when the Prime Minister went on December 19th, almost more than 2 weeks after the incident. The Tamil Nadu government also submitted their demands. We want, the Home Minister is here. Kerala has asked for 7,340. Yes. And in Tamil Nadu, National Highway 98 kilometers, State Highway 75 kilometers have been totally destroyed. Sir, cyclone warning systems have let down the fishermen of Kerala and Tamil Nadu. It's time as it is in Tamil Nadu, fishermen are tortured. They are captured by Sri Lankan Navy. Kerala fishermen suffer from the attack of the trawlers and again from nature's fury. The nation must extend its helping hand to these people who brave the forces of nature to go out into the sea to catch fish, to help our people. I can well realize the sort of misery people in Shashi Tharoor's constituency, Thiruvananthapuram, they are facing, because the tip of India was the most affected. And strangely enough, sir, ISRO, Indian Space Research Organization, has its main headquarters in Thumba, in Trivandrum, which is the affected area. The satellites, from satellites you can see clear images of cyclone forming. Why Kerala, which is the ISRO, could not know, this is a tragic thing which needs to be looked into. Sir, there is a problem about disaster relief which will end. Yesterday we discussed, in Bengal we had floods in June, July, August. The money for those floods have not still been released. There is always delay. At the central level, they say that you've got state disaster relief fund and we'll decide about national disaster relief fund later. But when such a cyclone, such a natural calamity takes place, decisions should be taken in a jiffy, more quickly. And that's why, sir, there is an urgent need to review deployment of search and rescue aircraft and vessels by Coast Guard and the Navy in the vicinity of Thiruvananthapuram. These all matters need to be looked into. Sir, you would be surprised, last point, that the wind was so strong that fishermen in Kerala went all the way up to Maharashtra port and they took shelter. You can imagine, they crossed the whole coast of Karnataka and then went to so it was a really terrible thing. They should be compensated for their loss of boats. And now the government should swing into action on this matter, and we must have a figure from the government of India as to, according to their reports, exactly how many fishermen have been killed up to now and how many fishermen are still missing, because people in the coastal areas are searching for their relatives in Thuttur and all other places. Thank you, sir. I thank you for allowing this discussion. We are not from these areas. Our heartfelt sympathies to the people of Kerala and Tamil Nadu and Lakshadweep. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Honorable